My name's Michelle McColl, and we're organic fruit growers, primarily apple growers. We have a small mixed farm. We're located just near Kalangadoo in the southeast of South Australia, not too far from the coast. It's a temperate, mild climate, terrific soil, well drained. We started here growing apples, and it was almost monoculture, just apples. And over the years, we've tried to develop into quite a diverse ecosystem. So from four varieties of apples, we now have over 90 varieties of apples and probably 30 varieties of stone fruit. If you have a year where the weather is bad for one particular apple, you've got a lot of other things there that you can fall back on. So both economically and agronomically, as far as growing things, to have diversity is a really good thing. Different types of fruit ripen at different times of the year. We start with peaches just before Christmas, which is terrific because leading up to that time there's not so much fresh fruit about. And after the peaches, sometime in February, the apples come in, and because we've got a wide range of apples, that continues right through till late May. As far as the orchard goes, we're into pruning, and as soon as we finish the pruning, there's tree training and tying limbs down, and then thinning apples, which means that we only want one apple in each cluster. Originally there may have been five or six at each of those, so we've had to remove a lot of the fruit, and that's a very labour intensive job. It's a much bigger job than picking, and by the time we really finish the thinning, it's almost time to start picking. We sell the apples locally at farmers markets in Mount Gambier in the Limestone Coast and also in Adelaide. And we also supply direct to a few fruit and vegetable shops and independent supermarkets. We also supply a few organic box schemes in the city as well. In addition to selling fresh fruit, we also value add, and that includes making juice, drying fruit, making apple cider vinegar. And if the fruit's not good enough for that, we give it to the pigs. We have two Wessex saddleback pigs, Baba and Celeste. We have a couple of dairy cows, which we milk for our own use. We have two Maremma dogs, which protect the chooks, and geese as well. The geese are used as for weed control. The chooks are used mainly for insect control, and of course they've got the advantage of producing eggs. We feel that biodiversity is really the key to an organic farm.
I guess what we're really trying to do is model the design of our orchard on a natural forest system, where you've got a different range of trees growing, you've got understory plants, you've got animals, you've got good insects, bad insects, and you get this natural balance. It's just really trying to have that diversity to get, you know, spiders, wasps, frogs, chooks, geese to do a lot of the work for you. So rather than using a chemical to control the pest or the weed or whatever, get an animal to do it that has other benefits. So that's what it's really the principles are about.